Hello everyone, Buzz Killington here, back with another character showcase for you, and today's is Arjac, Champion of the Great Wolf. The latest Space Wolf character to be added to the Tacticus roster. Now I know when I did my Space Wolf predictions, some of you in the comments were very keen at this guy being included, so I hope you're happy about it. Excuse me. Let's take a look at him. He is, as this the image and his legend suggests, an absolute unit. Let's take a look at him. Yeah, he is a beast. He is a beast in combat. Boom, nice meaty thump with his hammer. I just love the iconography and design. The shield in particular looks really, really good, doesn't it? Really enjoying the look of that. He looks pretty damn fierce. So I thought I would start by showing you his stats at rare. So as you can see here, this should be what he'll be when you unlock him. Would of course silver one rank, I've pushed it as high as it can on that. So at this level of development, we're looking at health of 1329, armor of 315, power hits, 3 melee hits, 278 damage. So he is a beast. He is strong in close combat. He has no range, virtually no range, but we'll get to that in a minute. But of course, movement 2. He is a Terminator. He gon' be slow. Let's read the description. A former Iron Priest of the Forge, Arjac, or possibly Ariac, is a towering mass of muscle and a taciturn anvil of endurance who upholds the honor of the chapter. Wielding the enormous foe hammer, Ariac crushes his enemies with pulverizing strength. So let's see. This is his trait. He is resilient, so he's going to stick around for a while. Interestingly, he has deep strike. He shares that with Angrax and with Ithana. Very useful ability to have. Stop it. Terminator armor. The first hit each turn against this character deals minus 75% damage, unless of course it's psychic or direct. So yeah, it's going to take a while to take him down, and he is going to be an absolute terror to dislodge once he's in close combat. But now I'm going to take a look at him at the higher level just before legendary, and hopefully due to my power of using transitions in my software, it should look a little something like this. I hope that worked. So here he is at epic level, level 35, as high as he can go before hitting legendary status. So it's worth pointing out right now his armor has jumped to nearly 700, his health nearly 3000. So yeah, he's going to be sticking around for quite a while. Power, still 3 melee hits obviously, 613 damage each. So he lays into your character, he is going to feel it. Your character is going to take a lot of damage from this guy, as you would expect. So I'm already thinking, as I say, this guy has good opportunities to be used in legendary events where his resilience and his power usage enable him to fulfill some quest criteria, and in things like Tournament Arena. And I'm going to go into specifically why with Tournament Arena in just a minute. But let's have a look at his abilities, starting as ever with the passive. It's the Anvil Shield. Ariac blocks an additional 285 damage, and when he blocks, he covers the attacker's hex in ice. If, and this is two criteria here, if either he is below 35% health, or if his attacker is on a health hex covered in ice, he gains an additional 19% block chance, and his block stuns any melee attacker until the end of the attacker's next turn. Stunning, for those of you who don't remember, is it reduces the unit's movement to 1, deals desolate damage, and cannot use active abilities. That is a significant effect. So bear in mind as well that Ariac could synergize well with Ulf using his active here. Ulf uses his active, he throws down a lot of ice around the active target. Catch someone else in it, Ariac moves in, uses his ability, or just uses his passive. When the attacker, someone goes to attack him, chance of stunning him, increases the block probability. Give him some strong armor, some strong blocking items, and strong boosters, and yeah, there's a very good chance that he's going to be negating a lot of damage and inflicting some serious inconvenience on your opponent. Let's take a look at his active. Foe Hammer. If you've ever played Halo, the original Halo, you're going to know why Foe Hammer reminds me of that. Basically, he can lob his hammer at you. Might as well be called Thor's Hammer, mightn't it? You can attack a target unit within range 2 for 1 times 142 to 285 damage, and a target is stunned. In fairness, I too would be stunned, mostly that somebody's lobbing a hammer at me and smacking it off my temple. The key part is here. For each character that has been defeated in this battle, this ability deals plus 856 damage. That is high. That is really high. Look at the leap, plus 43 at the next level, so maybe as much as plus 1,000 by level 40. If you ever wanted to get him that high, he would be an absolute beast for that. So, pretty much guaranteed to one-shot almost anything in a legendary event. And he will do significant damage in tournament arena. Just imagine it, Arjac is still sticking around towards the end of a game. Your opponent's down to 2 characters, say. Arjac uses his active on one of them. Bam. Huge chance of just completely killing that character straight up. Or at least inflicting significant damage and stunning them into the bargain. So yeah, I think tournament arena, definitely where this guy is going to thrive. But yeah, as ever, I'm now going to try and go into the sandbox. We can have a little demonstration of him in action, as I like to do. And I'm going to have another go at trying another seamless transition. And here we are with my usual set of punching bags for these tests, the orcs. So as you can see here, we've got a little defensive formation set up just to kind of demonstrate what's going on. You can see straight away, Arjac has decent damage against all of these ones. He's got the high ground, but if we move him down, he's still doing reasonably well against a character like Gulgortz, who is, of course, no slouch in the toughness department. But yeah, I just want to show how this will work pretty nicely. So, thing to bear in mind, let's use Ulf's active. He takes the orc out, or goes down. Now, bear in mind, and this is important, Tjark and Arjac cannot move through ice with the same effect as Ulf. Ulf lays down the ice and he just does not care. He will just go through it no problem. These guys are inhibited by it, so it is worth bearing that in mind. However, so we can see here, he moves in there, he's going to hit him for 298. But if we use his active on them, bear in mind, for each character that has been defeated, plus 655 damage. Let's see what it can do. Big hit. I love the animation, by the way. The actual, he's just like, yeet. I just love it. And he's just snap round. It's like, yeah, that would get his attention, I would think, yeah. But yeah, plus that is a significant amount of damage. He's taken like 2/3 of the health off him straight away. This guy is stunned now. He can only deal minus 50% damage. He cannot use active abilities. He's got the big target thing because he's standing next to Killer Can. But yeah, he's basically done. So he's going to step in. He's going to try and look at that. It's pathetic. He's going to try and do damage. He's barely going to achieve anything. Killer Can's going to come forward. Why not get some shots off? Why the hell not? So let's see what he can do. Again, just on his own. Woof. Big hits, big hits. We'll let Ulf finish him off. And, right, look at Tjark. Look at Tjark here. Tjark has such a great advantage here. He can really lay in some big damage on this guy. So he's going to come in with his physical attacks. 1% pierce ratio. But he is going to get in there. Let's use his active. Oh, the big chop didn't go well for him. But yeah, we'll get Tjark to finish this guy off now. Or near enough. Teamwork. So there you go. That is Arjac in action. I love his animation. He's a cool character. Usefulness-wise, you're not going to see him a lot on the battlefield. I can see people putting him in their arena teams you could make really nasty resilient arena teams. Put him in with Marnius Kalgar, for instance. That is going to be an absolute pain to deal with. But where Arjac is going to thrive, I think, is in tournament arena. There are great options, especially with his deep strike ability, letting him zip across the battlefield first turn to get into prime position, and he will just not be dislodged very easily. Not to mention, again, as we've covered, his active ability, the more characters that die, the stronger his active becomes, and it becomes a literal sledgehammer by the end of things. So yeah, I think he's cool, limited utility, but I'm still keen to unlock and collect him anyway. But it's not all about me. I know, it's hard to believe. It's not all about me. Let me know what you think about him in the chat, in the comments. Are you happy with it? Do you think he's true to the lore? I think he's pretty true to the lore. I love his look, as I say. I love his weapons. He's got a great artwork on him. Do you think you're going to get a lot of use out of him? Are there aspects of the how he can be used that you think I've missed? Do you think he'll thrive in game modes that I don't think he won't? Let me know in the comments. I always value your opinions. Thank you for watching. Until next time.